Hi, guys. I know it's been a little while since I've done a live video, and I'm not sure if anybody missed me or not, but I thought, hey, why not? Let's get going today. It's been a little while, so today I had a cooking show with Holly Bone, so if you know her, you could place an order with her for her show. And I came home, and I'm like, oh, I want to have some pulled pork sandwiches for dinner. Whip up something that's easy for John to take to work, something that, you know, that I can make in my rock crock, and it's really going to be simple. So today, we are going to be whipping off pulled pork sandwiches, but I'm going to make a homemade barbecue today. And the way that you would do this, I'm actually going to be making it in my rock crock on the stovetop first to make up the barbecue sauce. And then I'm going to actually throw the pork tenderloin into my rock crock and cook the rest of it off all in my rock crock in the microwave. So it sounds pretty crazy, but that's what we're doing today. So when I make homemade barbecue sauce, basically I don't measure. I don't measure anything that I do. I just kind of throw things together. Even at my shows, I have a tendency that if we're following a recipe and we're doing an interactive show where I have everybody jumping in and doing things, I pretty much will say, oh, skip this step or do this or don't measure that and just add this, you know. So I'm not one to measure. Now, I know a lot of you out there may not like to chop onions, okay? Onions do not faze me. I like to eat onions. I like onions. The smell doesn't bother me, you know, touching them doesn't bother me, but I know I have some texture people out there that don't like to deal with onions or even chop them at all on their own. I know you're touching these, you can add gloves, but what you can do is if you want to make this simple and you want to chop them without using a knife, all I'm going to do is throw them into my manual food processor, which has a removable blade. And what you're going to do is just add the lid on. It's really great for chopping. I make sauces. I chop up pretzels. I chop up peanuts for Christmas time or at Easter when we're making things rolled in nuts. So you could do all sorts of different things. And what you're going to do is just basically put this on the manual food processor. You're going to put the lid on, and it is a removable blade. Uh-oh, I have a surprise special guest today. Oh, I know a lot of you out there like when my buddy joins me. So, Brody, are you going to join me?
Mommy.
What, honey? Okay, well, we'll go down in a few minutes, okay? Will you help me show the girls and guys out there how to do this manual food processor? Can you help me? Probably say hi to everybody.
Hi.
Okay, I'm going to move you over so everybody can see you. Okay, so this manual food processor is so easy that Brody can do it. Brody, show them how it's done. Okay, I lied. I got to get it going for them first. It's stuck. All right, now show them. All right, Mommy, hold it. You go. Real hard. Brody, you're making this look hard. Let me get it going. Here you go, silly man. Push hard. Oh, no, I think he has to go lift some weight. It really isn't as hard as Brody's making it appear. You want to try it again?
Yeah.
Real fast. Go real fast. You have to push down with your hand. Look at it. See, that's what you're... There you go. Now keep going. See, I told you he's making it harder than it really was. Real fast. Fast, 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 fast. Fast. Okay, thank you for being my assistant. Okay, so I'm going to chop up my onions really quick here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take the onions and I'm going to put it into my rock crock. And you'll see how fine my onions got, okay? What's nice about this, and just give me one second, I'm going to grab a scraper here. What's nice about this is when you do your onions, they can get really fine. The faster you go with your manual food processor, the finer it's going to chop. It comes with a removable blade, and then it comes with a storage lid. So if you're making like salsas, a bruschetta, things like that, you could put your lid on and then store it in the fridge, which makes it really simple and really easy. And then all I'm going to do is take my onions. I'm going to dump them all inside my rock crock here. And I'm not going to show you everything. I'm going to show you how to make the barbecue sauce. I'm going to show you how I insert the pork, and then I'll come back in a little bit once it's all created. All right, so to make the barbecue sauce, you're going to use onions. You're going to put in about a half a stick of butter, which is what I have here. I like Kellner's personally. You can make your own, too, homemade butter. So I'm going to put that in. And what I'm going to start to do is just put them on my stove and start to fry them up a little bit. And then what you're going to basically be doing is in order to continue with your barbecue sauce, we're going to be adding ketchup, which sounds crazy, mustard, and then brown sugar. And that's how you can make your own homemade barbecue sauce. The more brown sugar you actually add, the sweeter it's going to be. Uh-oh, Pop-Up's on. Say hi, Pop-Up.
Hi, Pop-Up.
Oh, Paula's on. Say hi, Paula.
Hi, Paula.
Paula wants to know if she can come over for dinner. Should we feed her or not?
Yeah, we should feed
her. We should feed her. Say, Daddy goes to work, so you could come join us.
You could come join us.
Say, Pop-Up, you could come too.
You could come too.
I don't know. We'll probably have... Uh-oh. Jay's eyes aren't bothering him, Jimmy. Are your eyes bothering you from the onions?
No.
No. See, he's a tough kid. He's too busy looking for his girlfriend, Claire Bear, right now. He only came in because he heard me talking on the video. Right, Broadman? Okay.
Peeble.
Are you entertaining everybody? So I used two onions in order to make this. And then, like I said, I'm going to fry them up. So I'm going to take you guys with me now. So come on, we're going to take them for a walk here, Broadman. And I have my stove on with the Rock Crock. And I have it on high heat just to kind of get it going. I know you can't see this, sorry. Okay, it'll just take a few minutes. Now, what I also could do, and in fact, let me show you this. So I want to get this going even faster. What I can do is stick it in my microwave to kind of get those, the butter melted. And to get it going a little bit, I can do that. So I can put it in my microwave. And obviously my Broadman, I think he just went out. Yep, he went out. And once I get this going, I'm going to fry up those onions just a little bit. I'm going to add in my ketchup mustard and then my barbecue. And then I'm going to throw in that pork tenderloin and stick it all in the microwave to cook. Now, John is not home right now. I actually sent John for buns because these are my crazy ideas that I get when I come home from a Pampered Chef show that I'm going to cook all this food. Oh, and he's back now. But John, look it. You're live on Facebook Live.
Just press the button.
So, and I told you he went. Okay, that's okay. I was going to send him to make, get cabbage, too, so I can make homemade coleslaw to go with this, but he didn't get it. Bear with me here. I have a tickle. Let me stick that back in. John distracted me there. All right, so we're going to melt that down, and he picked up buns, so you'll be happy to know if you're coming and joining us for dinner tonight, you'll be having pork barbecue with buns, because, of course, I got this brainstorm after the fact. Oh, yes, he did, Paula. You know it, right? John, Holly said I should send you to hang out with Joe right now. He's not answering me, Holly. I don't know where he went. He probably heard me on the video, and he's like, I'm out of here. I'm not dealing with her on there. Okay, so now my butter hopefully should be melted more. There we go. It's starting to melt more. Okay, so let's kind of get this going. So do any of you out there make homemade barbecue sauce? Do you do it any differently? What do you do? Tell me your recipes out there. Get type in there, everybody. I want to see how you make it. Or do you buy the store-bought barbecue? We buy that, too. I have barbecue sauce, too, in the fridge. But I just, for some reason, when I make pork barbecue, it has to be homemade barbecue. I think it just, I don't know, I just think it tastes a little bit better. Okay? So now my onions are starting to get going here. They'll get moving a little bit here. You know what? Let me bring my video thing here. I don't know if you guys can see. So if I stick you on the video camera. Sorry if I'm shaking here. Let's see. I don't think I can make it that it goes down. Let me see. Oh, there we go. Okay. So now that is starting to get moving here. You see that the butter's all melting. So you won't even taste the onions in your pork barbecue. It just kind of, they'll soften the onions up a little bit. It adds some extra flavor, I always feel like, when I add those. So now what I'm going to start to do is, like I told you, I don't measure, so I'm just going to start to stick in everything here. So I'm going to add my ketchup. The mustard kind of gives it a little bit of like a tartiness. So a little bit of mustard. And your brown sugar. And I use Great Value. It doesn't matter what brand of sugar you use for this. I do a lot of my grocery shopping. We pick stuff up at Boyer's. We pick stuff up at Walmart. We get a lot of our meats over at Marlin Markets, which is where I got the pork tenderloin for today. I got that. That's where we got that. Aldi's has some great deals on stuff. All right, so now I have my barbecue or my sugar in. And then you just start to mix it. Now, the sugar will break up and kind of crystallize a little bit here. And then you'll be able to mix it really nicely with your ketchups and your mustards and the onions. Okay. And basically, all I'm going to do is let this get a little bit warmer. It'll start to boil a little bit. And then what I'm going to do is once it starts to boil a little bit and gets really hot and steamy here, I'm going to throw that pork tenderloin in. Now, what I could do is I could have done the pork tenderloin too and added the barbecue sauce later. But I really like when the meat cooks with the barbecue sauce because I just think it really adds to the flavor of it. I'm going to see what other... I can get some more ketchup out of this. These are my brainstorms I get on the weekends, you know. Instead of going grocery shopping, planning it out, I'm like, oh, well, what can I whip off here today? All right. So now, it's getting there. I can feel the heat coming. It's getting there. Now, I'm going to add the pork tenderloin. Now, some of you may think I'm crazy, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and stick this pork tenderloin in, this big, nice piece of meat that was from Marlin Markets. I'm going to cover it with my rock crock lid, and then this is going to go into my microwave for about 25 minutes. So you're not going to see from me, you won't see from me here for a little while. You won't hear from me at all. So what I'm going to do is stick this in the microwave. Hey, Justine, how are you? Got to give a shout out to everybody out there. I'm going to stick this in the microwave. Cook it for about 25 minutes in my rock crock. When it comes out, I will jump back on live and I will show you how I use my salad choppers to chop this all up, and you will see how fast and easy you can have dinner on the table. Now, like I said, I turned my stove on and kind of got the barbecue going a little bit, melted everything down. You could stick that all right into your rock crock and do it all in one shot if you wanted to. I just always like to kind of taste the barbecue to make sure it's what I liked, and you probably didn't notice, but I snuck a little taste in there, just to make sure it's what I wanted to taste like and make sure it's the right consistency as far as the sweetness goes, with the amount of sugar that I put in. So, hey Katie, it's good to see you. Well, actually not see you, but see that you typed to me. Yes, Brony. Oh, and look it, he found his hot woman, Claire.
I guess I got today from my mom.
What did you get from your mom?
A leopard.
Whoa! Say hi to everybody out there.
Hello.
This is Brody's future wife. She's lucky that her mother-in-law-to-be likes her.
Come on.
Hey. Back up. You gotta back up so they see you.
I got bloody fingers.
Okay. All right, you two go.
Open.
Okay. On that note, they have bloody fingers, and I'm not sure what that's from. What are they from? Who bought you these, Lindsay?
No.
Where'd you get these at?
I got these from the pumpkin hunt.
Oh, okay, well, hold us. Okay, so anyways, I'm going to actually go and get dinner done now. So I'm going to go ahead and throw my rock crock into the microwave. So I'm going to move everything. And I'm going to show you to put this down. Sorry to make... Okay? And you'll see that I'm going to put this all on for 25 minutes. And we will be back so I can show you how it's finished. Okay?